Aki Kareem for British Boxers, and we are down here at VIP Gym in Astley today, Jamie Moore's gym, and we've got unbeaten Stephen Ward with us, Belfast zone as well.
Belfast zone.
How are you, man?
Good, mate, good. Haven't seen you well. How's things? All good?
Yeah, good. Very good, very good. Well, we're down here today doing a bit with all the gents, and of course, you've got a big fight coming up.
Yeah, good fight. Just under 4 weeks now, so really cracking it up, feeling good. Looking forward to it on the biggest show to come to Belfast, Northern Ireland and Ireland in general. So excited about it.
And of course, your opponent in Steve Collins Jr. Obviously, people who follow the boxing know that surname's a household name sort of thing.
Yeah.
Does that sort of change your dynamics of preparations in a fight when you're fighting someone who's got sort of a pedigree in a family sort of thing?
No, not really. Well, not for me anyway. I think, you know what, performance I control is my own. I'm happy enough to just focus on what I have to do and how to do it right. As Steve Collins, everyone knows Steve Collins, especially back home, like, he's massive, do you know what I mean? He was such a success in boxing. But yeah, it doesn't mean that his son's going to be. You know, he's a good guy like Steve. You know, we've met on a couple of occasions, you know, chatted, hung out. Dead on fella. It's going to be a good fight.
Yeah, it is going to be a good fight. But before we get onto the sort of the dynamics of the actual fight, I do understand that you're on decent terms. I mean, you've been out for dinner before and all that sort of thing.
It sort of happened out of the blue. It was we were both on a small hall show, and we just happened, just by chance, we went into the same place some day. We were sitting chatting, had a bit of food together. He got up 5 minutes before the end. I finished the meal, got up, left, and he'd squared off the bill. You know, it's usually what type of fella he is. He's a decent fella. But it's obviously come fight night. You know, we're both there. We're both trying to get ahead of each other. We'll shake hands before. You know, shake hands after. You know, reason why not?
Yeah. Now you're 7-0 now.
Yeah.
You know, would it be fair to say that you're not really had to get into sort of third gear yet?
Yeah.
So this is going to be your first sort of real test.
Yeah. 7-0. Had a couple of tough journey, man, and stuff, but nothing to write home about. Sorry, card from just in the background there, messing about seriousness of the gym. But no, you're right, 100%. It's the first real big test, which I'm excited about, you know, putting the butterflies for this fight. Something that I used to get all the time in amateurs, getting a bit now in pro. So I'm excited to have a step up and really put on a good performance.
Stylistically, you know, he's a come forward, aggressive sort of fighter. You know, you can be longer rangey and can box as well. I mean, do you think that style wise he's right for you, your sort of boxing style?
Yeah, I'd say so. I think, you know, working here with Jamie and Nige, I've developed a lot of the parts of the game that I never would have really focused on before, about working inside as well, which I'm excited to use for maybe the chance to get the first time to do it in this fight. You know, I'm a big stand-up textbook boxer. Excited about having someone that's going to come forward and be in my face the whole fight, you know, to really push me on. I think it'll make an entertaining fight, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and of course there's an added dynamic because it's Dublin versus Belfast now.
Aye.
You know, I believe that's sort of similar to sort of a Man United versus Liverpool sort of scenario. Does that add pressure? I mean, do you like it when it's a cauldron atmosphere? I know you've got a big following yourself, so is he. Are you looking forward to the atmosphere?
I think atmosphere will be brilliant. It's Windsor Park,
yeah,
you know,
Windsor
it's
Park,
a big,
yeah,
it's,
yeah.
It's, you know, of course the atmosphere is going to be, it's going to be massive. But the whole Belfast Dublin thing, it does add to it. You know, so much of what has went on Belfast Dublin, you know, with, you know, like Hank Tro McKenna is the most, you know, the man who used to say most that started the sort of Belfast Dublin. He was always fighting Dublin fighters, Dublin v Belfast, Belfast v Dublin. So it definitely adds a wee bit more zest to it. I'm excited about it, you know.
Yeah. I mean, you, in terms of records, you've taken this fight on with a guy with a decent record and good pedigree, you know, a fairly early stage of your career. I mean, is that a sign of things to come from yourself? Obviously, touch wood, you know, from your perspective that you get through the fight. Is that a sign of things to come? You're looking to progress. Each fight now is going to be a building fight?
100%. You know, it's as you said, you know, it's my first real test. I like being in the gym and I like having an end goal, and at the minute, you know, when I was fighting, you know, these build-up fights and getting used to it, it was good. You don't get me wrong, it was good to sort of taste the environment and what it's like being a pro, but now I really think like I'm ready to kick on. You know, Steve Collins, 12 wins, 1 loss, do you know what I mean? He's a good record. You know, you get a lot of boys in the weight categories, it'll maybe go 13, 14 fights and not really fight anyone, which it's just not for me. You know, I need a bit of a challenge, I need a bit of a butterfly in the tummy, and I think this fight gives me it. And I think get over this one, all being well, then from here on we just plan to kick on. I think with Jimmy and I, it has big intentions, we plan to be busy, and MTK are always giving me the best fights.
And in terms of your setup here, obviously all the lads getting ready to train today. Mm-hmm. You just had Rocky Fielden as well winning the WBA
Brilliant.
Regular title, which is great news.
Champ.
You know, the camp is buzzing. Carl Frampton in here as well. Jack Catchall onto big things. All the lads, Conrad. I've not missed anyone, have I?
No.
Right, good. Just check it. You know, it's a good sense of unity in the camp as well. But really, it's an individual sport at the end of the day. So how do you sort of distance from the buzz and what everyone else is doing for just sort of pursuing your own goals?
It is an individual sport, yeah, 100%, but it's behind the scenes, it's not, you know, it's like any sport, even someone that, you know, it's okay, I'm getting in the ring and it's me, but, you know, behind, you've your strength coaches, you've the Jamie and I telling you what to do tactics-wise in the gym. You know, when you're in here training with all the boys and you're doing tough circuits, you're pushing each other on, but yes, okay, deep down in your head, everyone has a bit of a their own personal goal or their own tactics or their own outcome at the end of, you know, the training session, but we're all training as hard together, do you know what I mean? It's even we all might have a different goal we're trying to reach, or a different fight or a different tactic we're playing, but we're still all training hard. And it's not even in the gym, it's outside the gym. You know, me and the boys, me, Frank and Conrad live together over here, you know, with a bit of crack, it makes training so much easier. You know, we come in the gym and Nigel just slavers to you as soon as you come in. He just, you know, and Jamie just sits and laughs and videos everything, so it's good crack.
Yeah. Well, you're looking in a good place, and looking forward to this fight. It is a good fight. It's a test. It's a genuine fight, and looking forward to the whole show.
Brilliant.
Appreciate your time, Stephen.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, man. Cheers.
Cheers.